Hey, this is Jesse Canty. Man, I am so glad that you took the time to download this podcast. Listen, it's getting ready to be a blessing to you. It is power-packed full of wisdom. Listen, as you hear this episode and you want to be a blessing to this podcast, well, you can hit me up on Cash App. Type in Jesse E. Canty, J-E-S-S-E, the letter E, C-A-N-T-Y, with the dollar sign, of course. And you can be a blessing. Anything you give will be appreciated. I thank you, and I pray that nothing but God's blessings and his best be upon you. Take care. Hey, this is Jesse Canty with another episode of How Bad Do You Want It? This podcast is meant to encourage you. It's meant to motivate you. It's meant to light your fire and strengthen your determination. There comes a time in everybody's life that you will feel like a loser. But I'm here to remind you that though you have suffered some loss, you are not a loser. You are a champion. That's why I'm calling this one The Last Dance. Can I talk about it? Let's go. Yeah, man.
Man of wisdom, man of wisdom. From the pulpit to the podcast, from the pulpit to the podcast, to the podcast. Yeah.
Hey, this is Jesse Canty with another episode of How Bad Do You Want It? This is episode number 66, and yes, I'm calling it The Last Dance. I'll explain it a little bit. Let's start off with prayer. Father, we thank you right now for the opportunity, God, to discuss this word, Father, where what you have given me. I pray right now, Father, that you lead me and guide me, God. Let it be a blessing to someone, Father, in a unique way. We give you praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Well, if you haven't realized it, this podcast here, and I'm going to go through it quickly, it is meant to encourage you in a unique, different manner. This is something that the Lord laid upon my heart. Anybody that knows Jesse E. Canty, I'm telling you, there's only a few little things about me that are kind of strange or a little different or certain ways that I like certain things. Well, anybody that knows me, they know, I said it before, they know I like Mighty Mouse, and my wife know that. I like Superman, but I also like Michael Jordan. I love the Lord, but I also like Michael Jordan. I love chili cheeseburgers, but I also love Michael Jordan, man. I love Michael Jordan so much. I'm not talking about to the point of worshiping nobody. I mean, there are some people out there, some Christians that like you so heavenly, you can't enjoy ice cream. You can't love butter pecan or whatever it is. No, I'm going to live. I'm going to enjoy myself. I've always loved Michael Jordan. I've been to a lot of his games. I've been to his baseball games. I got a bunch of his shoes I'm sitting here looking at right now, boxes, a bunch of them. I even named my baby boy Jordan. Got put in the newspaper over. So enough of that. I love Michael Jordan. My wife gave me on one of my birthdays, she gave me a picture of Michael Jordan with a powerful quote that he said, and she put it next to my bed. So every morning I wake up, it encouraged me. Now, you're going to think I'm crazy, but let me first of all say the Bible said that David encouraged himself in the Lord. Yes, we are to encourage ourselves in the Lord through prayer, through his scripture. We can do that as well. And I have done that. But let me tell you something. You also can be encouraged through outside circumstances or natural circumstances or natural people. As you live this life on this journey, this is not to discuss their salvation. This is discuss their motivation. You ever had some people around you that when they come around you, do you feel like you can do wonders? Let me tell you something. Those are the people I want in my corner. It's a few people, man, I'm starting to talk to, man. When I talk to them, my wheels get to turning. My mind get to, when they get, the more they talking, my mind start getting creative. And I'm like, man, let's get together. Let's hook up, man. We can conquer the world if just me and you and get another people on our page or stage that we own, man. That's the type of people that I love to have around me because it encourages me. Well, that's what this right here is about. Now, y'all understand about The Last Dance, the docu series that came out, the 10-part docu series that came out last year. With Michael Jordan, it says it's basically about the fall of 1997. Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls allowed a film crew to follow them, y'all. They went there. They went for their sixth championship. And that'd have been the NBA title in 8 seasons that went there, because 2 of them Michael Jordan was retired on. That resulted in a stunning portrait of one of the most iconic athletes, which is Michael Jordan, and a celebrated team, The Last Dance. That's what came out, the docuseries. And it was covering a 10-part docuseries, follows Michael Jordan timeline from when he was emerging star in high school, on a high school team. Actually, he got cut the first time he went out, and that's another thing I'm going to talk about. And then that docuseries became a worldwide marketing force for this figure, culture figure, Michael Jordan. The series takes its name from the phrase coined by the head coach, Phil Jackson. He knew this was going to be the last season that they would likely have a final run at the championship and be together. So he called it The Last Dance. I'm calling this one The Last Dance as well, because it's reminding me of that even when it seemed like you're back against the wall and you probably on your last chance to make it, even at that time, you can still find something deep within you to motivate yourself. One of the things about Mike that I love a lot of stuff about Mike, and y'all will hear a lot of it right quickly, because I'm going to fill this episode with his quotes. Since he wasn't available to sit down and do an interview with me on this podcast, I believe something came up. So since something came up, I'm going to go ahead and bring him to this podcast with his quotes. This man was cut. The Michael Jordan, who is what we believe, we got an acronym called the GOAT, mean greatest of all time. And one of the things I love about going to the barbershop, we get to debate little stuff like this. Who's the GOAT? You know, there's people out there saying Wilt Chamberlain the GOAT. They say Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is the GOAT. A whole bunch of them believe that Michael Jordan is the GOAT, and I do too. And you got a few of them that's crazy that say LeBron is the GOAT. I don't know why they say that. It's such sacrilege. But anyhow, Michael Jordan, hands down, in my opinion, is the greatest player of all time, all around. But anyhow, so with that being said, can you believe that this guy got cut from his high school varsity team? I read one thing that says he didn't get cut. Technically, he didn't get cut because he didn't make the team. Well, he didn't even make the team. He went home and cried to his mother, man. And his mother encouraged him. His daddy told him, "We use it as a motivation." That's the thing about it. Mike knew how to use rejection as a motivation, as his motivation. And listen, when you've been rejected, and I believe as Dr. Martin Luther King would say, that the way you defeat your enemies is success, is succeed. So when you've been turned down for something that you know that is in your destiny, you don't throw your hands up and run away and give up. You go back, sharpen yourself, sharpen your skills, increase your determination. That's why I love a lion. And my baby boy is starting to love lions too. And I hope he uses lions the same way I use them in my life. They're not a perfect creature. They don't kill everything. They don't have moments where they're not scared. But at the end of the day, a lion is a bold creature that doesn't give up, and he lets his hunger push him beyond what his ability can do. You got to reach deep down and ask yourself, how bad do you want it? And let your hunger push you to stick with things that normally you would have given up. Now, the first thing that encouraged you is you allow the word of God to encourage you, because heaven and earth can pass away, but his word going to stand through everything. There's nothing stronger and better than encouraging yourself with God's word. But you also can be relatable and encourage yourself through the words or the lifestyle of certain people that you have lived and been just as much as human as you have. And Mike would say several things. One of the things Mike would say, some people want it to happen. Some people wish it would happen, and others make it happen. I'm going to throw one more in there. And then you got that group that don't know what happened. they don't know nothing what happened. Some people want it to happen. They wanted this. I want water, but I don't feel like getting up looking for it. I'm motivated by so many things. One of the things in the scripture where the four lepers made a decision. And if you don't know that story, go find it. The four lepers said, "We can't go where we came from, go back where we came from, because they're gonna reject us. They threw us out the city. We can't go into, if we go over to the enemy's camp, then we may get killed or either get put in prison. prison. He said, then one of them spoke up, but we can't stay here and do nothing. We can't just sit here and want to eat and want to survive, but no good well, it ain't going to come to us this way. So let's take our chances. And they made a decision. Some people want it to happen, but they won't make a decision. Some people wish it would happen, but you never put any action behind it. And then there's a few people that makes it happen. That means that you sit here and you do your study, you do your preparation, and instead of blaming people and blaming the white man and doing this other stuff, you put your hand to the grindstone and you make it happen. And again, you got that other group that don't know what happened. Stay away from that group especially. Another quote by Mike says, if nobody will help you, do it alone. Boy, I love that. I remember hearing him say that. Then he said, there is no I in team, but there is the letter I in win. If nobody will help you, then you got to have enough internal fortitude, determination. You got to have enough inward motivation to do it alone. It's like you thirsty. You know, if a man's sitting there on that couch, he being lazy, he thirsty, he keep hollering for his wife or somebody to bring him something to drink. If that woman never bring him nothing to drink, I guarantee you, unless he's crazy, before this man die of thirst, he'll get his rusty dusty up off that couch and find him something to drink. So if you ain't got no help, then you got to motivate yourself and look within. I've been there in life. I've been there where it seemed, because I always looked around. My wife and I talk about this often. I always looked around and said, man, if I had the help that some other people have had, whether it was ministry, whether it was business, whether it was just the backing of people in your life, I said, man, it seemed like I always got to do it the hard way. And I asked God, why it seemed like I got to do it the hard way? Never got an answer from it, but you know what? God have always taught me to put my hands to it and say, you know what? If you want it, then you got to make this thing happen. And with God's strength, you can do anything. Another statement, encouraging statement that Mike would say is, I can accept failure. Everyone fails at something. But what I can't accept is not trying. I like that. I can accept failing. Everybody fell at something. There are some people who have a fear of failing. There's one particular person, man, I would not call this person out because they related to me. This person is gifted. This person have things to do in life. And I be wanting to scream and say, man, if I was had the stuff that you have, bro, I would be having 10 times the money. I would be having a whole different lifestyle. But sometimes they don't see their own gifting. Even if they're listening to me now, you are an awesome, gifted individual. Why are you afraid to fail? Don't be afraid to fail, because everyone fails at something. I don't care how many people that look like they're successful. If they sit out and tell you the truth, they have failed, and they have failed in a lot of things. But what you ought not be able to accept is not trying. I refuse to die and not try. And one of the things we always use, this is another I'm going to throw in, this came to me. One of the things we always use in the barbershop to say that Michael Jordan is the greatest is that this man was 6-for-6. He went to 6 NBA finals and have won all of them. We use that argument as him being one of the greatest. But when they tell Mike that, Mike say every time he hear he was 6-for-6, it eats at him. Because he wanted the chance to keep going until he lose. Now, I wouldn't have said that. I said, I want a perfect record. He says, no, I can accept failing, but I can't accept not even getting to the point where we didn't even try in that area. He wanted to keep going until they took it from him. I thought that was different. Another saying of Mike said, my attitude is that if you push me towards something that you think is my weakness, oh man, I love this. Then what I will in turn do that perceives, he says, then I will turn that perception of weakness into my strength. Hear that again. My attitude is this. If my enemy pushes me towards something in my life or keep coming at me that you think is my weakness, then I'm going to take that in turn and make what was my weakness my strength. in basketball terms, if you keep trying to make me go to the left because I don't use my left hand, then I'm going to practice privately enough on my left hand where when you push me to what you think is my weakness, it have now become my strength.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Hey, thank you for taking the time to listen to this podcast. God has blessed us to have listeners all around the world. And I thought to myself, I said, maybe there's somebody that wants you to have a prayer request, that wants you to pray with them concerning anything, your family or whatever it is. If that's be so, listen, drop me an email at jessecantypodcast@yahoo.com. jessecantypodcast@yahoo.com. I would love to hear from you. I love to pray with you. And I want you to have a blessed day. And again, that is one of the things, in my opinion, that makes him one of the greatest, because all around he had no weakness in his game. He actually lived what he just quoted, that if he found a weakness, he would work on that until it become his strength. Do you imagine how you would be or who you would be in life if you went through life not trying to hide your weakness, but allowing the things of life to expose your weakness? And when they exposed your weakness, it became your homeroom, your homework assignment to make your weakness your strength. By the time you go halfway through life with that mindset, you have become a powerful individual or a powerful instrument in the hands of God, because you are focusing on not being bigger, but you are focusing on being better. Mike said, all I knew is that I never wanted to be average. That sounds like something I told my mom when I was in third grade. I do not want to be average. Let me say it another way. I do not want to be ordinary. I believe the God that's inside of me, I can have the potential to become extraordinary. It's amazing how average people will always try to give their opinion on people who are extraordinary. But you're not, you can tell me how I should walk on water and how I don't look right walking on water, but you have never walked on water yourself. You ought to have a motivation and a desire that I refuse to die average. I believe I'm better than average. I am not the best thing out there. I say that hands down, but I believe I'm better than average. Another powerful statement. I want this thing to encourage you, and I'm just encouraging myself as I encourage you. Mike also said, obstacles don't have to stop you. If you run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it. Go through it or work around it. If you don't let your obstacles, because you can't read. That was Moses. Moses said, I can't talk. And God told him, I made your mouth. Figure out a way to go around it or to climb it or go through it. Obstacles do not have to stop you. You got to be able to overcome every obstacle. Another quote was saying, you can practice shooting 8 hours a day, but if your technique is wrong, then all you become is very good at shooting the wrong way. That's a lot of times how we go through life. They got an old statement saying that practice makes perfect. And we found out that's not true. It's perfect practice that makes you perfect. So sometimes we can just keep doing things over and over and over and over. If you get off the horse, I've always said this, if you get off the horse, get back up again. And that's not my statement. If they ever make a wisdom book of certain statements, Jesse don't believe in that. Jesse believe if you fall off the horse, get back up, dust yourself off, examine for a moment. What did you do wrong that made you fall? And then make an adjustment and get back up there. And if you fall again, do it again. After making your adjustments, you're going to stay up on that horse. You can practice 8 hours a day, but if you're practicing with the wrong technique, then all you're doing is just shooting the wrong way. So find out, what are you doing in life? I've seen people open 5 or 6 different things or do different business or whatever. And at some point in time, we have to go find somebody that's doing it and say, what am I doing? But you know what? Pride don't want us to do that. We'd rather keep missing shots instead of going asking somebody, what am I doing wrong? Bring perfect practice to the table. Another statement by Mike, it says, if you accept the expectations of others, especially the negative ones, then you will never change the outcome. I'm talking to some champions. And champions should not be turning around listening to no losers. Because their expectation is low. He said, if you accept negative and these expectations of other people, then you will never change the outcome. They're going to always be right. Turn the volume down in your head on what they say. Another quote of Mike says, you must expect great things of yourself before you can do them. If you don't expect great things of yourself, then you can't do them. I don't got to add no more to that. But expect it. Know that God have not made no junk when he made you. God made you as a champion. You are awesome in the hands of God. Your potential is extraordinary. But you got to know that. And then you can make some changes. Another statement says, sometimes you need to get hit in the head to realize that you're in the fight. I believe sometimes God allows some situations to actually, you feel it. It wakes you up. My wife says something. She says, in your older years, she said, you always been quick and you move. She says, in your older years, she says, I've never seen you drag your feet at all until you start getting a little older. There's sometimes I may set back and get in neutral. I may take two or three days and I may not do much of nothing. And she know I got stuff I need to do, but I be in neutral mode and don't do it. But then there's a time when the house is on fire, figuratively. She said, I'm going to tell you, you get to moving. You take it all over. And that's what it is. Once you get hit in the head and don't realize you're in a fight, you should be sitting back waiting on nobody else. So people who ain't got the strength and ain't got the desire to fight for themselves and make it happen, let them get hit in the head. It'll wake them up. Another statement of Mike says, I'm not out there sweating. I like this one, y'all. I'm not out there sweating for 3 hours every day just to find out what it feels like to sweat. He said, when I'm out there practicing and waiting and all the sweat I'm creating, I'm out there to win. Don't get it twisted. I ain't out there for no other issues, no other agendas.
I'm not sure I understand. I'm
not out there to waste my time. I'm out there to win. That's what Mike was saying. Watch this. He also said, my father used to say that it's never too late to do anything you wanted to do. And he says, you never know what you can accomplish until you try. It's never too late to do anything that you want to do. And he says, you never know what you can accomplish until you try. Quit sitting back wishing or hoping one day you're going to do this and that. These years are ticking by so quick, you ain't going to be here by the time some of y'all go put your hands to do what you want to do. You got great expectations of you that God have placed upon you, and you have to put your hands to the plow and do what God tell you to do. You'll be able to surprise yourself. You might be able to surprise yourself. Mike says sometimes things may not go your way, but the effort should be there every single night. We're not talking stuff like this and telling you that you cannot lose or you a thing or you gonna always win in everything. No, but always put forth your best effort. No matter what you're doing, always put forth your best effort. Another statement of Mike, he says, I realized that if I was going to achieve anything in life, I had to be aggressive. I had to get out there and go for it. You can't be weak. You can't be passive and get up to the plate and barely swing that bat and expect to hit it out the park. If you swinging for the fences, you got to be aggressive. The early bird gets the worm. You have to get up early and be on point, on time, not only in that way, but even whatever field you put in your hands to do. If you got 30 people in that class, then your assignment is to be number one. At least put forth that effort to be number one in that class. Another, just I want two more statements. One, he says this, heart is what separates the good from the great. If you're going to be great, you got to have heart. I think his old statement that says it's not the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog. Not only you can be of smaller stature and still be bigger, but you can also be, you can have less than anybody, but you got a fight in you like that of a giant, and you'll take less and do more with it. Last one, Mike will say, always turn a negative situation into a positive situation. Old folks would call it be a teachable moment. Instead of looking at what went wrong, find something positive that you can bring from it, that you have learned. Let you get some tuition. Let that pain be that tuition. Get some knowledge and some understanding out of every situation. What did you learn from it? Every day we are striving to learn, to be better, to be stronger. And every now and then, I don't know how many people like stuff like this, but every now and then you need to get surrounded around someone that can sharpen you. Let iron sharpen iron. We can encourage one another with the motivation that God has given us. The tenacity that God is. These are words that I've looked up 1,000 times and I love every one of them. Motivation. Determination. Tenacity. Diligence. I mean, you got to be on point, man, to where you are standing and you're standing lifting up the standard and you refuse to give up easy over what you have become your dream or your goal. Listen, I call this thing the last dance because it reminds us of Mike, how that last year when they got that last word from their coach and said, this is the last dance, they could have said, well, since we ain't going to win anymore, let's just go ahead and just, they could have took that last year as woe is me and have went out there and played miserably. But in turn, they turned around and let that and coined it the last dance and let it become their motivation to where they took it, they repeated and won a 6th NBA championship finals. How are you going to take the cards that have been dealt to you and how are you going to play them to your advantage? If this don't encourage you, I don't know what can. It should encourage you to get back out there and turn that thing around. No matter what's been said, no matter what's been squandered, no matter what mistakes been made in the past, you got the right to rewrite your destiny. And for that one right there, I want to pray with you. Father, I thank you right now that you have placed this upon my heart. I pray that it touched somebody, God, that it blessed them in a special way, God. I thank you right now. Let the Holy Spirit lead and guide them, Father, in every way that they go. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Know that I love you. Y'all have a blessed one.
Hey, business owners, this is Rashad Brown with Swipe Fast, located in Columbia, South Carolina. We are excited to be partnering with Jesse E. Canty and the How Bad Do You Want It podcast. Since 2017, Swipe Fast has been helping business owners like you save up to 99% in their debit and credit card processing fees. So if you process business to business or business to consumer payments, we have solutions that will meet your needs and would love to hear from you. You can reach us at swipefast.com/save. That's Swipe, spelled with a Y, or contact us at 1-800-597-0713. Don't forget to let us know that Jesse E. Canty sent you. Have a blessed day.